Let's talk about how we graph lines using intercepts that specifically go through the origin. These can be a little troublesome because they don't work in a typical way like they usually do if we're graphing using intercepts. And so let me show you how to handle this. If you're doing a normal problem where you're graphing using intercepts, you'll take your linear equation, you'll find your x-intercept, you'll find your y-intercept, and then you're able to connect the dots and you'll get the graph of the linear equation. It would look, you know, something like this. It's pretty straightforward, not really a whole lot to it. Find your x and y intercept, that gives you 2 points to connect the dots. And you need 2 points to uniquely identify a line. And the x and the y intercepts are those unique points. But if your graph goes through the origin and it's a linear equation, then it's a little bit different ball game, because here, let's look at an example. If your x-intercept is at the origin, then that will also be where your y-intercept is. And so you have 2 points. You have an x-intercept, you have a y-intercept, but they're the same point. They're at the same place. And so there's not 2 points to connect anymore. And so what do you do? What do you do if the x and the y-intercept are at the same location? Well, if you recall, when we talked about graphing linear equations using intercepts, one of the things I highly recommended doing was picking a test point. And in that scenario, the test point was not necessary. It was just a good idea just to make sure your points are lining up on a straight line. But now it's going to be a little bit more important, because now that test point will be serving as the second point. And so when you pick your test point, then it will become clear what your line looks like, and you can connect the dots as we typically do and get the graph of your linear equation. All right, so if we want to jot these down as some steps, it goes something like this. If your line goes through the origin, then what you'll do is you'll plot your x and y intercepts as you usually would. The only catch is that you'll realize that they're going through the origin. You'll see they're going through 0, 0. And so if you see that happening for your x and y intercept and you only have 1 point drawn because the x and the y intercept are at the same location, then you must plot a test point. It's no longer an option. You really need that extra point to serve as your second point to help you see the line. And then step number 3 is the same as it always is. You'll simply draw a line through those points. So let's try an example here. Let's say we have y equals negative 2x. And maybe you might not even know that this is going to go through the origin until you start getting into the math, and that's okay. So you don't think that you have to do anything really different. So if you're trying to graph this using intercepts, we'll start, let's say, with the x-intercept. Okay, if we're looking for the x-intercept, we know that we're supposed to let the y value be 0. And then look for the x-coordinate that would correspond to a y-value being 0. To solve for x, we divide both sides by negative 2, and so x equals 0. All right, so my x-intercept, I let y be 0, and I discovered that x would be 0. So right off the bat, I know my x-intercept is at the origin. And it doesn't take me too long to figure out that the y-intercept will also be at the origin. So if I jot that down real quick, for the y-intercept, I'll let the x be 0, and we'll have y equals negative 2 times 0, which is obviously 0. And this guy is not only the x-intercept, but it's also the y-intercept. It's both. Okay, so if you were to plot those two only, then here if I do a y-axis and an x-axis, then those two are in the same place. That place is where it crosses the x-axis, and this is where it crosses the y-axis. I can't uniquely identify a line there. I mean, there's 1,000 different lines. This line goes through that point, this line does, so does this one, so does this one. And so that's not enough to uniquely identify a line to uniquely identify a line, I need 2 points. So here's where I will bring in a test point, an extra point that used to be an option. Now it's no longer an option. So for the test point, what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug in any x value that hasn't already been used. So I'm not going to use 0, but any other x value is fine, even 1, just something other than 0. If we plug in 1 for x, negative 2 times 1 makes negative 2. So this is an ordered pair that's on the graph of this line. And so I'll plot that. I'll plot 1, comma, negative 2. That's down here. And now I can actually see what that line's going to look like. This line's going to go through both of these points. And we'll get something that looks kind of like this. And we're done. That's it. So it basically just elevates the importance of the test point from being optional to being required. But other than that, it's not too much different than plotting a normal x, y intercept and finding the graph of any other linear equation.